Hello everyone, welcome to Sushmas kitchen. Today I'm going to show you a very tasty Mughlai chicken recipe. There's a very tasty recipe for rotis and chapatis and rice also. Hope you will like it, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share my videos and click on the bell icon for further notification. First we need to marinate the chicken. I have taken here 1/2 kg 500 grams of chicken, boneless chicken. You can take with bones also. I'm adding 1 teaspoon of rock salt and 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, and 1 teaspoon of red chili powder goes in this, and 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, and 3 tablespoons of curd yogurt. We have to mix this well and keep this aside for 30 minutes, minimum 30 minutes. If you have time, you can keep at least for 1 hour. You have to keep this aside. And now I'm going to take a pan with 2 tablespoons of oil for the gravy. I'm adding all the dry spices, the bay leaves, cinnamon sticks, cloves, and 2-3 cardamoms. I'm just tossing them, and in this I'm adding 2 onions, 2 large onions. I'm adding in this and let it cook for 2 minutes, just 2 minutes. And for 2 large onions, I'm gonna add 4 tomatoes, 4 large tomatoes. This is 1:2 ratio, so I'm adding 4 large tomatoes in this, and we need to cook the tomatoes, onions well. That's it. This is a basic gravy we need to have for the Mughlai chicken, and I'm gonna add some dry spices like turmeric, the coriander powder, garam masala, 1/2 teaspoon of each, and rock salt. 1 teaspoon of rock salt I'm adding. Rock salt gives a nice flavor and taste. Mix it well. And in this I'm adding 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste also. Fry this well for 2 minutes and cover and let it cook for 5 to 10 minutes till the tomatoes and the onions are cooked well. If you want, you can add a little bit of water, otherwise it's okay. Sorry, I forgot to tell you that we need to add 10 cashews also in this for the richness for the gravy. Now in a pan, I'm taking oil, 3 tablespoons of oil, and 2 tablespoons of butter, and I'm gonna add the marinated chicken and cook well for at least 10 to 15 minutes. We need to cook, don't add any water in this. Let the chicken cook in the oil. Just for 5 to 10 minutes, just toss it. Don't cover it, otherwise you will get a lot of water. So just cook like that. So you can see the water is coming out from the chicken naturally. It comes, and after some time, like after 5-10 minutes, the water, all the water goes, and the cook and this cook chicken, because this is a boneless, it cooks very fast. If you want, you can add bones, with bones also. Now this is done. I've kept the chicken aside. I have taken in the same pan 2 teaspoons of oil, and I'm adding in this 1 teaspoon of kasuri methi and 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. Just tossing them in the oil, and I'm adding the gravy which I have grinded, the onion tomato paste which I have done before. I have grinded it into smooth paste. I'm adding it. If you want, you can add little water also. Otherwise, you can just add some milk instead of water. Just toss it well for 2 minutes. Just mix it well. So now I'm adding 1 cup of like half a cup of milk. You can add for the richness. Now I'm adding the cooked chicken also, fried chicken, the gravy, and we have to just keep this for 5 to 10 minutes. That's it, the gravy is done. After adding the chicken, after 5 minutes, you can I'm gonna add the fresh cream also in this. The fresh cream and the milk gives you a nice rich taste, the cashew paste and everything. See, after 5 minutes I've taken, and I'm adding the fresh cream in this. Just gives a nice flavor and taste for the chicken gravy. If you don't have fresh cream, you can add some mughlai also in this. Now let it cook for another 5 minutes, and that's it. The mughlai chicken is ready. It goes very well with rice, the pilav rice, or rotis, or chapatis, or naans. Any type of breads, it goes very well, and it's so tasty. You have to try this. Now it's done.